Hey, happy holidays, YouTube. Today we're going to take a look at the iOS 10.11 jailbreak on an iPhone 7 Plus. So hopefully this works out for us. I'm going to grab it from the official mirror. The website will be in the link below, description below. And then we'll also need City Impactor. If you don't have City Impactor installed from the previous jailbreaks, we'll be sideloading this jailbreak into our device. So make sure you grab the latest version and install it on your Mac. I have it running right here and my device is plugged in. I also have the download from the jailbreak website, which is an IPA. It's about 14 megabytes in size. I don't suggest you download that jailbreak patch here from anywhere else, just because you don't know who has put what in it. The next thing we're going to need to do is go onto our iOS device. So on your iOS device, you'll have to trust a certificate once you install this using City Impactor. First thing you'll do is drag it into the City Impactor like you see me do here, and then begin entering in your Apple ID. And then this process takes just a moment. If you get this verification box saying that it'll revoke your tickets, you can just hit OK. And you might get an email from Apple saying that your developer certificates have been revoked. But all it has done is revoked the previous ones and renewed them. Mostly happens if you've sideloaded other applications. We're finished on the computer. That's actually it. City Impactor works pretty good. Usually there's no issues there. So on our device here, I'm just going to quickly move. So I put the application on the home screen page. You'll see the application installed from the jailbreak here. Just make sure I remain in focus. So this could work right off the bat and be good, or you may need to reboot and try this a few times. If it doesn't work on the first try, you will have to reboot again. The first thing you'll have to do is tap on it and it'll ask you to trust it. So you can just hit cancel and then go settings, general, scroll all the way down to device management, choose the Apple ID, hit trust and trust. And then you can leave this and go back to your main home screen. So from here, we're just going to start the jailbreak. It takes about 15 to 30 seconds. Once you open the application, all you get is a white screen. This device hasn't been jailbroken yet. I have tried this on another device before I decided to make this video. So hopefully this one works right away. Now, if your device goes to a black screen after like 10 to 15 seconds and begins like rebooting with the Apple logo, that means that the device has failed and it's going to restart. You actually have to power the device down and then restart the device again. Hopefully this is going to work here, since it's staying on the white screen here for a little while. Usually is a good sign. So this appears to have failed. The device is just frozen. I'm just going to leave it just for a little while longer. So from here, we're going to have to perform a hard reset on the iPhone 7. It's the power button and the volume button at the same time. So allow your device to reboot. Okay, unlock your device. And we're going to try again. Usually when the device reboots, give it a few moments while it just does all the background tasks it usually does when it starts up. You know, you can actually see here I do have Siri installed, so this did work. My device did freeze up, and we have rebooted it, so I will have to relaunch my jailbreak here. And here we go. So there we are. We're jailbroken now on iOS 10.11. As you can see, I ran into a bunch of issues with it, with this device. I actually had the same results with another device that I previously jailbroke to test this out before I did this video. You will be able to delete the jailbreak launch application. So this is a semi-tethered jailbreak. You have to launch this application to use Cydia to get into a jailbroken state every time you reboot your device. And this application is what Lucas Tedesco will be updating to support more devices and make the jailbreak more stable. So once that happens, once he updates this, I would definitely recommend you guys jumping on the jailbreak train. For now, as you can see, it kind of glitched out a little bit, but I am successfully jailbroken, so job well done. Thanks for watching, guys. I hope this video helped you out. If you run into any issues with the jailbreak, let me know in the comments below and I'll make tutorials on how to fix them. Thanks for watching. We'll see you guys again soon. Cheers.